Hello friends, welcome back. Let us solve some more problems. Okay, now read the question. Two soil samples A and B, each weighing 1 kg. I'm having water contents of 50% and 75% respectively are mixed together. What is the resulting water content of mixed soil? So come on, tell me the answer. What is the value? There is a soil sample A. There is a soil sample B. A is having a water content of 50%. B is having a water content of 75%. What they are saying? They are mixing together to forming a new soil type C. Then they are asking us to find what will be the water content. What is the value? So directly I'll say, as I'm mixing together, I'll say 50 plus 75, 125 divided by 2. So what will be the answer? So the water content will be 62.5%. Is that right? Wrong answer, right? As we have already discussed, seen in the form of void ratios and porosity, isn't it? Then, how can I find out? Again, the same procedure. So, what is the water content? That is nothing but a weight of the water divided by weight of the solids. So by using the given data, you have to find out what is the weight of water and what is the weight of solids. Then you can think of finding the water content percentage. So just like see the case A, soil sample A, what is the total weight? They have mentioned that it is 1 kg. And what were the water content percentage given? 50%. So what is meant by water content? Nothing but a weight of water to the weight of solids. That is given as 0.5. So from this, what is the weight of water? That will be equal to 0.5 times weight of the solids. What about total weight? Express this total weight in terms of the weight of water and solids. If I express this, I can say total weight is nothing but a weight of water plus weight of solids, that is given as 1 kg. Now substitute this relation here. If you substitute this relation, weight of water 0.5 Ws plus Ws, that will be equal to 1 kg. So weight of solids, that is given as 1 kg divided by 1.5. Can I write any shortcut here? Here I can say my weight of solids is equal to 1 kg is nothing but a total weight of the sample divided by 1 plus water content. So we are getting then my weight of solids is equal to the 1 divided by 1.5. How much it will be? 0.67. So out of this 1 kg, what is the weight of solids? 0.67. Then what about the weight of the water? Nothing but a 1 minus 0.67. Then we can say it is a 0.33 kg. Right? Similarly, talk about the sample B. It is also having a weight of 1 kg. But it is having a water content of how much? 75%. So by using this relation, you can directly find out what is the weight of the solids. That is nothing but total weight is 1 divided by 1 plus water content is given as 0.75. That will be equal to how much will get? 1 divided by 1.75. It will be around 0.571. So this is nothing but a weight of the solids. From this, what will be the weight of the water? So weight of the water is nothing but a total 1 minus 0.571. Then how much will get? Will get as around 0.429 kg. Now you are mixing these two samples together. Then what will be the total weight of solids? From A, weight of solids 0.67. From B, weight of solids 0.57. So 0.67 plus 0.571. How much you are getting? 0.67 plus 0.571 will get is around 1.24 kg. So this is what weight of the solids present in the sample C. Then what about the weight of the water? as we have discussed in the previous case, voids may change, but the amount of water content will not change. Similarly, what about the weight of the water? Here 0.33 from sample A, from sample B 0.429. Then if we are adding these two, how much will we get? We'll get this around 0.759 kg. That's it. If you are talking about the sample C, now what will be the water content? That is nothing but a weight of the water divided by weight of the solids. Weight of the solids we obtained, it is around, weight of the water is 0.759 divided by weight of the solids is nothing but 1.24. So how much you are getting? If you solve this, you will get it is in 0.612. Then how much percentage? So water content of the soil sample C is 61.2%. Understand? Okay, like there is one example. This is one way of doing, and as you studied more subject in W for finding the concentration into water content, like that you should not do it at all. So always these are not the proportionate values. So wherever they are mixing any two soil samples together, so just find out the values corresponding to the conceptual case. Okay, next. What is given here? A soil sample has void ratio of 35%. The specific gravity is 22.7. Determine porosity, dry density, unit weight. What do you think? Can you solve it or not? How? What is the void ratio is given as 0.35. And what was specific gravity? 2.70. And also they have given 75% saturation. Then whatever the degree of saturation we have to consider, we have to consider it as 0.75. What about porosity? Tell me quickly. What is the relationship? E divided by 1 plus C. How about dry density? We know Z value and we know void ratio. Then how can you find out? Dry density is nothing but a gamma W into G divided by 1 plus C. Take this in gram per cc. Then what are the value will get in also gram per cc. Then what about the unit weight? That is nothing but a gamma. That will be equal to, if you recall, gamma W into G plus SC divided by 1 plus C. Just in the meanwhile, I just given this formula oriented question so that we will get confidence. That's it. Right? All the values are directly given. Just if you remember the formulas, then you will know the solution. Right? Then move on to the next question. What is given here? A sampler with volume of 60 cm³ is filled with saturated soil sample. Okay. And once again, a sampler, it is having a volume of 60 cm³, is filled with saturated soil sample. Okay, fine. When woven dry soil is poured into a graduated cylinder filled with the water, displaces 40 cm³ of water, determine the water content. So here, what we have to find out? We have to find out the water content. How can I find out the water content? Water content is nothing but a weight of the solids to the, sorry, water content is nothing but a weight of the water to the weight of the solids. Then, how can I find out it? Come on, think about it. How can I find out those values? Okay, let us start from the basic. What are these data we know? We know the volume of sampler. Sampler is nothing but a, the soil we are collecting. So, what is the volume of soil sample we know? We know it is equal to the 60 cm, or simply I am saying it as a cc as our convenience. And what are the other things we know? When woven dry soil is poured into a graduated cylinder filled with the water, then it displaces 40 cm³ of water. What about Archimedes' principle says? So if it is displacing a water of 40 cm³, then what is the volume of water? So here we'll say the volume of water is nothing but a volume of water displaced. What is the volume of water displaced? That is nothing but a 40 centimeter cube. Isn't it? Is it correct or wrong? Wrong. Why? Because, so what they are saying? They are saying that if you are taking the same soil sample, same sampler and fill with the water. Let us say they take the same sampler and completely fill with the water. Now, I'll take the same soil, but if it is in dry condition, and I will pour into this sampler. So, as I'm pouring this dry soil into sampler, what will happen? The water is displacing out of it. So, how much volume of dry sample I have poured? How that much volume only will go out of the sampler? So, that's why what is the volume of solids? This will say it is 40 centimeter cube. Then what about the volume of voids? That is nothing but a 60 minus 40. That will be equal to 20 centimeter cube. Right? Now, based on this, can we find out what will be the, finally, we have to find out the water content. So we don't know any weight, right? Do we know any weight density or specific gravity? If you know the specific gravity, then only we can find out the weights. As you don't know the weights, as you don't know the specific gravities, we cannot find out the weight density. Then we cannot find out the weight of the solids. Then what is the another approach? As we are always evolving with the volume something, then we should use this help of volume and we have to find out the water content. So can you find out what will be the void ratio? Void ratio is nothing but a volume of voids to the volume of solids. That will be 20 by 40. That will be equal to 0.5. So we know voids is 0.5. Then, and also we know as it is completely saturated soil, then we know our degree of saturation is equal to 1. Then what about G value? So here the mistake is they didn't mention the G value. So let us consider your G equal to somewhere around 2.7. So if you don't consider G value or if they don't give, then we cannot solve this problem. Why? Because at one, somehow we have to find out, isn't it? Why? Because what is meant by water content? Water content is nothing but a weight of the water to the weight of the water to the weight of the solids. So if you see here we know volume of voids, that is equal to 20 centimeter cube. As it is completely saturated, then what I can say that it is equal to volume of water. Why? Because as there is no air present, then volume of air is equal to zero. Then this is completely of nothing but a volume of water. If I know the volume of water 20 centimeter cube, then what will be the weight of the water? Then the weight of the water is nothing but a 20 gram, isn't it? So I can say that my weight of the water is nothing but a 20 gram. Then what about my weight of the solids? How can I find out the weight of the solids? That is nothing but a, we can use the help of true specific gravity. What is the true specific gravity? True specific gravity is nothing but a weight density of solids divided by gamma W. What is the weight density of solids? We can say weight of the solids divided by volume of solids. So here I am just considering gamma W equal to 1 gram per cc. What about the Z value given? 2.7. That will be equal to weight of the solids divided by what about the volume of solids we have obtained? Volume of solids we have obtained is 40 centimeters cube, right? So that divided by 4. That's it. That implies what is the weight of the solids? That will be equal to 2.7 into 40. How much you are getting? We are getting it is around 108 grams. Then what will be the water content? Water content is nothing but a weight of the water equal to weight of the solids. That will be equal to 20 divided by 108. That will be equal to, if you are solving this, we are getting it as around 18.51% is, right? So this is by using how? By using the weight density approach. Is there any other approach? Yes. Now we already know your E value is equal to the 0.5. So we know your E value equal to 1. And also we know degree of satisfaction equal to 1. And we know that our Z equal to 2.70. Then what we need? We need to find out the W. What is the relationship between these three? We can say E equal to W into G divided by S. Your E, we know it is 0.5. That will be equal to water content that have to find out into 2.7 divided by degree of saturation. So tell me how much you will get it. So even if you solve this approach, then you will get your water content as 18.51%. Like previously we have followed the approach of by using the weight density, but here we can directly use the relation U equal to WG by SR also. So this relation, I think this is the most useful relation coming to other. Move on to the next problem. Okay, let us just stop here and we'll continue in the next lecture. Thank you.